If you're tired of your Minecraft lagging, stuttering or freezing at the worst possible moment, then this is the video for you. Today I'm going to show you the exact settings you can change to instantly boost your frames per second, lower your input delay and make Minecraft feel way smoother, no matter what PC you have. You don't need any mods or any specific software, just a few simple settings that will get you the smoothest Minecraft experience you've ever had. So as you can see right now, my frames per second is just under 120, but even if you have an FPS of 20, we can fix that. So to fix that, press escape, then go to your options, then go to video settings. You want to change your graphics settings from fancy to fast. You will barely notice a difference in the way the game looks, but your frames per second will be way higher. Now moving on to render distance. If you have a good PC, 12 will be fine, but if you have a lower end PC, 8 chunks should work just fine for you. You can change your simulation distance all the way down to 5 chunks. Moving on to max frame rate, even if you don't have 120 FPS, change it to unlimited and this will give you better FPS. Next we have clouds. You can turn off clouds, but if you like to see the clouds, just change the setting to fast. This way you will still see clouds, but the game will be faster. The particles I like to change to minimal, but if you're playing with other people and they use potions quite a lot, you might want to keep that on. Mid map levels should be on off, and that's basically all of the important settings. A few other settings you can change but I don't recommend is entity shadows and smooth lighting. These settings don't make the biggest difference, but the game will look way worse if you turn this off. If you decided to keep clouds on, you can change the cloud render distance, and once you're done, you can just click on done. Then go out of the settings, and as you can see, my frames per second will be way higher. One last tip, if you play on a laptop, it's really important to keep the power cable plugged in. I will now plug it out, and as you can see, my frames per second will instantly drop. It will stay really low, and as soon as I plug it in, the frames per second will go way higher. I really hope you found this tutorial helpful. Thanks for leaving a like and subscribing, and I will see you in the next video.